called Step Forward and Repeat the Phrase You've Been Given. Understand?
Canadian fashion mogul Peter Nygaard was arrested Monday night and is being held here at the Remand Center in Winnipeg after being indicted on 9 charges, including sex trafficking and racketeering in the U.S. Nygaard was arrested by RCMP Monday night at the request of the United States under the Extradition Act. A news release from the United States Attorney's Office for the Southern District of New York says the charges involve at least dozens of victims in the U.S., Canada, and Nygaard's private island in the Bahamas, as well as other locations over a 20-year period.
Imagine climbing over a cliff to get to your bed. The next home on our tour is one of the world's largest and most unusual. It's twice as big as computer billionaire Bill Gates' home. Well, now. And Christie guarantees that we've never seen anything like it before. Take a look.
From a boat, it looks fabulously exotic. And from the ground, it seems even more so, filled with temples, fountains, even rare birds. One of the world's largest homes. This tropical fantasy took 10 years and over $30 million to build. This is the owner, Canadian mogul Peter Nygaard, whose mega successful company makes women's clothing sold everywhere from Saks to Sears.
It's like a personal resort. It's big. It's about 150,000 square feet.
In fact, Peter's home is so big that guests need electric cars to move around the compound's 4 acres.
You're going to drive into your house.
Peter designed the place himself, ensuring that each of the 20 bedrooms has magnificent views. Each room has a name and a personality. This one is called Cliffhanger, built so it literally dangles over the sea.
Come on, this is truly Robinson Crusoe.
Oh my gosh.
You gotta watch how it rocks.
This is the ultimate water bed.
Yeah.
Peter says he built his home to go back to nature, and so he used native materials everywhere, from this shell sink to wooden tub. Naturally, Peter entertains constantly here, making sure his guests enjoy every luxury from indoor-outdoor pools to full-size tennis courts. Visitors include Sean Connery, Michael Jackson, and his favorite, George Bush. Peter says his greatest pleasure now is improving his fantasy home.
150,000 square feet. That is a lot.
Can I tell you, he loves spending money, and the next thing he's going to do is build a huge lagoon that you dive into, swim to a cave, and you'll find a disco and a wet bar. Is that cool or what?
I just said to Christy, I am not living large enough, I reckon. Thank you so much, Christy.
Thanks for having
Thank
me.
You so
More than 50 women have accused Nygaard of sexual assault, claims that date all the way back to the 1970s. His own sons say they, too, are among his victims.
Absolutely thrilled to find out that he's going to have to face a trial and go through the judicial process and not be able to just take off and with a pot of money offshore somewhere.
Nygaard hosted so-called pamper parties at some of his homes, as well as poker games and dinners. In Cordon in Winnipeg on behalf of the U.S., the FBI says those were ways he would get to his victims. The FBI calls Nygaard a predator, and they allege he sexually assaulted dozens, if not hundreds, of women and girls over a 25-year period and used company resources and staff to help him. Greg Gutzler's New York law firm filed a class action lawsuit against Nygaard in February. It was put on hold in August so that the FBI could complete its investigation. The lawsuit also alleged co-conspirators and enablers helped Nygaard commit his crimes.
There was a system in place, and there were dozens or hundreds of people involved in this thing.
Thank you. Nobody ever believed he was real. Nobody ever knew him or saw anybody that ever worked directly for him. You never knew. That was his power. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world he didn't exist.